Thanks for joining us for this edition of Orthodoxy Fact or Fiction. Now, in my previous video, I talked about the options available to you for an Orthodox funeral service. Today, what I want to do is take you through what is the process for the Orthodox funeral rite or the Orthodox funeral service. Number one, at the time of death, it is proper for the family to call the priest to the bedside of the deceased so that the priest can say the Trisayon prayers. Once those are said, then the preparations will begin for the funeral, the selection of the funeral home and things like that. Many times that's done beforehand. That next part is the wake service or the Trisayon service that is typically done the night before the funeral. So from the time of death until that Trisayon, there may be a span of time depending upon the amount of time it takes to deliver the body, to prepare it, so on and so forth. But that second part is going to be the Trisayon. Usually that is conducted at night, and it's usually conducted after the family and friends have had an opportunity to view the body and to pay their respects. Usually the next morning is the third part of the Orthodox funeral service, which is the actual funeral rite itself. That will always be conducted inside an Orthodox church. Now, if you live in an area or the person passes away in an area where there's not an Orthodox church close by, and I've done this many times myself by the permission of the bishop, we can use a nearby church, maybe like an Episcopal church or a Protestant church, where we can conduct that funeral service with permission from the bishop. But if there's an Orthodox church available, that funeral service is going to be conducted within the church. The next part is then going to be the interment. The interment is where we actually bring the body to the cemetery, and there we will repeat the Trisayon service. And then at that point, the family can stay if they wish to see the body then lowered into the ground. Now, I want to let you know that if you have a military funeral, you will not be allowed to go to the actual burial site. They'll bring you to a pagoda area where we'll conduct the Trisayon, and then the burial will actually take place at a later time. So for a national cemetery, it's a little bit different. But normally speaking, the burial will be conducted right away after the Trisayon service. And the final part is what we call the Makaria or the mercy lunch. So this is where now we have a lunch or a gathering, and a lot of times for Greeks, it's going to be a fish meal or fried fish or baked fish or something like that. And this gives us an opportunity to talk about the person's life. This is where we celebrate the joys and we laugh a little bit and we talk about our relationship with that person. So this brings me to an interesting point then. The Orthodox Church does not allow lay people to give eulogies in the church. Now, the reason for this is because we can't control what the laity will say, and whatever is said inside the church must be in adherence with Orthodox theology. So, unfortunately, we've had a couple of bad instances where people will say things that are not necessarily appropriate. So this is why we give the family and friends the opportunity to then speak about the deceased at the mercy meal, because we have to say something. So at a funeral service, the only people that are allowed to speak or eulogize are clergy. So the last thing I want to talk about is goliva. Now, goliva is offered typically at the 40 days, the 6 month, and then the 1 year anniversaries of the date of the death, okay, not the date of the funeral. And goliva is only allowed for those people that have had an Orthodox funeral. So if now a cremation has happened, goliva is not allowed to be in the church. Goliva is a rite that is restricted to those who have had a proper Orthodox funeral service. So sometimes people are not necessarily aware of that, and that's why we have to be very careful when we make these decisions about how we're going to conduct the funeral service, whether it be cremation or some type of green burial or outside of the church, because then it puts you outside of the church and then does not allow important customs and rituals like the celebration with goliva. So I hope that this has been informative to, like I said, at least let you know, number one, who can be buried, what are some options available to you, how is a funeral service conducted, and then a little bit of explanation about the proper use of koliva. So with that, I look forward to then seeing you all for my next edition of Orthodoxy Fact or Fiction.